Stockton, 15 minutes before 6 a.m. on your Friday morning. Looking good out there. Facebook has come up with another way to prevent you from leaving their site.
I guess that's good.
They have handcuffs?
Zareen's in the newsroom with what they've come up with.
Paul and Bethany is actually really bad. They are trying to take over Darren Peck's job. Let me show you how. So you know when you get invites, when friends send you, you know, little invites to go to the park or whatever
sure.
it is? Okay, so take a look at this one, for example. You see the name at the top. Let's say park picnic, whatever it is, the details on, you know, what's going to happen at that event, where it's going to take place and when. Now they're adding a little symbol right here, a little weather line. And so you see the forecast for the date and time when that invite is coming out. Now they're not only doing it for invites, they're also doing it for certain pages, for unowned pages like parks and cities. So for example, the Sacramento page, you see that right now it's 47 degrees, 47 Fahrenheit. They don't mention the windiness thing, so that's one thing where they're kind of lacking in that Darren can fill you guys on. But the cool thing is that they're actually not just putting it all over the place. It's not just, you know, on the news feed, Paul, now you know what that means. It's the main page on Facebook, right? They're putting it in really specific places, like places that you would actually look to go to if you're making a decision on if you want to go to, I don't know, the park or your friend's invite or whatever it is. So, interesting, but Darren, I'm sorry. It's kind of bad news for you.
No.
That cannot compare with Peck.
Oh, yeah. Well, as you pointed out, they didn't even say it was windy.
Exactly.
Your job is safe, my friend.
Did she just threaten my job? I've got it. Thanks, Zareen. I've got a little bit of weird science. Let's get into this. For today's weird science, I've actually got a theme. All three of these stories have something to do with birds. First, to the dinosaurs, where we meet some of the oldest feathered creatures. Now, some Chinese researchers are saying that those early birds may have had some help taking flight thanks to an extra set of wings. The study of 11 fossils found in northeastern China showed evidence of large feathers on the birds' legs, not someplace we'd ordinarily think of them. You think of the feathers being assigned to the wings. Here we have them down onto the legs. The researchers say that that may have played an important role in the evolution of flight, so kind of new insight on how that whole thing got started. All right, now fast forwarding to the present, we all know that roosters can make a racket
yes,
at
they
dawn.
Can.
But have you ever wondered why the dawn? Is
yeah,
there anything special about the dawn? Well, some scientists had been pondering the question too, so they ran some tests and they found that roosters, if you put them under constant lighting conditions, they will still sound the alarm at daybreak, whether they can see it or not.
They're so amazing.
They've got an internal clock that they're going on. Roosters are also known to crow at the sign of car headlights as well.
Yeah, okay.
They may not be the smartest in the bunch.
Well.
The new research confirms that increasing light doesn't throw off the internal clock.
And they don't get it. They don't get daylight savings time.
Yeah, they don't get daylight
savings
time.
That is a kick in headdress,
it's,
man.
It's kind of like my internal clock, you know, where I'm getting up at 3:30 sometimes on the weekends, whether the alarm's going off or not.
Oh, no.
And we saved possibly the tastiest kind of bird for last, the peep. I think we got inspired by this because there's been an open bag of peeps in the newsroom for like the last 4 weeks that no
Ew.
One's taking responsibility for. The novelty Easter candy sitting on the shelf at your local grocery store. If you were curious, the anatomy of a peep, it's a little more complex than just sugar. Have you ever read the ingredients on these things? There's corn syrup, gelatin, potassium sorbate, which is a preservative, and carnauba wax. That's the same
Delicious.
Ingredient used in car wax rounds, gum, and coffee beans. We just thought we would throw that in for fun.
And if you put them in the microwave,
they get this big. They're fantastic.
They just explode.
Nuke a peep. It'll change your life. They're fantastic.
All right, let's check in with Sheldon Orvis in the Fox 40 Traffic Center for your Friday commute.
Looking pretty good for this windy drive. 99 getting out of Elk Grove this morning. No stalls, no collisions as we work our way to